I'm in my 20s, and nothing seems like a for sure thing. At this age, I have three things I think about a lot: the dream of becoming a nurse, traveling, and having a family. However, growing up, I learned that oftentimes our plan does not turn out exactly how we picture it would be. I've heard the word no or you can't a lot, yet somehow I'm confident that I'm going to be just fine. This challenge to write or talk about the one thing I believe in that I know without a doubt is true had forced me to eliminate a lot of things in my life. I realized the many doubts I have and also the fact that I doubt myself a lot. Am I strong enough? Can I really do this? Am I good enough? Is this the direction I should be going? You see how life could be overwhelming? But this is not enough reason for me to quit. Soon, I will tell you the one thing that keeps me moving forward. But first, let me be honest here. I have written four of this I Believe project. First, I wrote about my dreams. Then, I wrote about music. I wrote about the story of my life, the value of my friends and family. These are all important to me. I am thankful to have dreams and to have the opportunity to go after them. I love music. I own a red guitar that I named Brave. That should give you an idea of how much that guitar means to me. I enjoy playing it and writing songs with it. Also, I value my friends and my family. I do not know exactly where I would be now without the support system I have. Besides all these good things I have also had a rough life. I felt lonely and afraid growing up, being passed around from one family member to another, and sometimes strangers, but I am stronger because of it. I sometimes look back and ask myself, how in the world did I survive through all that? Only God knows. That's it, God. I believe in God. He is the reason I have life, the one who keeps me moving forward. When he says no, I trust him. And when he asks me to do something greater than I can do with my own strength, he becomes my strength. Even if he says, give up my dreams, give up my guitar, leave my friends and family and move to a strange land, pick up the cross, take up death, and follow Christ. I believe that God is worth losing everything for. Why? Well, here's a famous sermon by Dr. S.M. Lockridge, which describes exactly the way I see and understand God, the King. My Bible says, my King is the King of the Jews. He's the King of Israel. He's the King of righteousness. He's the King of the ages. He's the King of heaven. He's the King of glory. He's the King of kings and the Lord of lords. That's my King. I wonder, do you know him? My King is a sovereign King. No means of measure can define his limitless love. He's enduringly strong. He's entirely sincere. He's eternally steadfast. He's immortally graceful. He's imperially powerful. He's impartially merciful. Do you know him? He's the greatest phenomenon that has ever crossed the horizon of this world. He's God's Son. He's the sinner's Savior. He's the centerpiece of civilization. He's unparalleled. He's unprecedented. He's the loftiest idea in literature. He's the highest personality in philosophy. He's the fundamental doctrine of true theology. He's the only one who qualified to be an all-sufficient savior. I wonder if you know him today. He supplies strength for the weak. He's available for the tempted and the tried. He sympathizes and he saves. He strengthens and sustains. He guards and he guides. He heals the sick. He cleanses the lepers. He forgives sinners. He discharges debtors. He delivers the captives. He defends the feeble. He blesses the young. He serves the unfortunate. He regards the aged. He rewards the diligent. And he beautifies the meek. I wonder if you know him. He's the key to knowledge. He's the wellspring of wisdom. He's the doorway of deliverance. He's the pathway of peace. He's the roadway of righteousness. He's the way of holiness. He's the gateway of glory. Do you know him? His life is matchless. His goodness is limitless. His mercy is everlasting. His love never changes. His word is enough. His grace is sufficient. His reign is righteous. And his yoke is easy. And his burden is light. I wish I could describe him to you. He's indescribable. He's incomprehensible. He's invincible. He's irresistible. You can't get him out of your mind. You can't get him off of your hand. You can't outlive him, and you can't live without him. The Pharisees couldn't stand him, but they found out that they couldn't stop him. Pilate couldn't find any fault in him. Herod couldn't kill him. Death couldn't handle him, and the grave couldn't hold him. That's my king, and I believe in him.